ESPN and the Professional Bowlers Association welcome you to Central Florida for the continuation of the PBA King of Bowling Series, powered by AMP. Today, from Lake Wales, the next to last wave of challengers to Wes Malott's throne take to the wood. And glad you're with us, I'm Rob Stone. Wes Malott earned the right to be this season's first King of Bowling by garnering Player of the Year honors. And so far, three challengers have tried to storm Wes's castle, and King Wes, well, he's remained impervious to their attacks, and he has absolutely dismantled his competition through here. It's not like he's been battling a bunch of court jesters either. Chris Barnes, Patrick Allen, Walter Ray Williams Jr., all three of them former Players of the Year. And then last week, Wes did it in grand fashion, dropping an audacious 300 on the living legend, Walter Ray Williams Jr. And we haven't seen a royal run like that since this guy, Randy Peterson, was the King of Bowling 16 years ago. Now look, we knew Wes had a wonderful season, obviously earned Player of the Year honors, but what he's doing this week is really adding to that legacy that you get the sense he's starting to build.
Well, it certainly validates what he did all season long. And what he's done to three of the greatest players in this sport has been truly fun to watch. It appears that the King of the Castle is unbeatable on the Scorpion Oil pattern. But interestingly enough, Rob, he did sound a bit concerned about one guy left in this event, and that's John Nolen. He said, hey, if John Nolen gets past his first match, he could be a handful.
It should be interesting. Now let's meet the King and tonight's challengers to his throne.
Three titles this season, earning the title Mr. Versatility. The big, nasty, and current three-time King of Bowling, Wes Malott.
I know it's been a great season, and you know, I'm finally fortunate enough to get this Player of the Year honors on my resume.
The 2007-08 PBA Rookie of the Year broke several rookie records in nearly every PBA Tour qualifying round record. He helped Team USA secure a team gold medal at the 2008 Men's World Championships. Rhino Page!
I wasn't prepared coming into this season, you know. I took it easy in the off season. I didn't work as hard. Kind of took things for granted for what happened last year. You know, with lack of preparation with my physical game and then lack of knowledge with bowling balls, it was a really tough start for me, and a rude awakening.
He won his first Lumber Liquidators PBA Tour title and major in his first television appearance. Running through the field at the USBC Masters in Las Vegas, it's smooth rolling John Nolen.
It was a pretty magical week. I was so in tune. As far as focus was concerned, it just was, I really haven't had a week like that before. I mean, my focus level was just at a level, it was so high that week. I was just so in tune. I never had anything like it.
Now, Brianne Pettigo working our lane side coverage. And again, Brianne, the focus is on King Wes.
That's right, Rob. All eyes on this guy, Wes. Many great players have tried. No one has been successful at taking the throne away from you. Your last game, a perfect 300. What does that do to your confidence going into tonight's match?
Well, I mainly just got to regroup, and you know, obviously the season's still going. It's been an unbelievable season, unbelievable wave, and hopefully we can keep riding it. So I'm just going to try and regroup from that and you know, make these guys definitely earn it.
I think the cape makes a big difference.
Could not agree more. His best entrance yet, but 220-something up-and-comers are going to shoot up next with the goal of usurping King Malott's crown.
The PBA King of Bowling, powered by AMP, is brought to you by AMP. AMP up. AMPenergy.com. By GEICO. 15 minutes could save you 15% on car insurance. And by Lumber Liquidators, hardwood flooring for less.
ESPN and the PBA welcome you back to our continuing coverage of the PBA King of Bowling, powered by AMP, coming your way from the beautiful Kegel Training Center, located here in Lake Wales, Florida. It's time now for the Lumber Liquidators. Know the wood, and no shocker here, it's the Scorpion Oil Pattern.
Well, let's just call it the West Pattern. 42 feet in length, and on both sides of the lane, early on, the players are going to start out pretty straight and then just migrate towards the center. Rob, you got a guy that's averaging 275 with a perfect game on it, and he's sitting on the throne.
Wes has been nothing short of dominant through this entire series. And we talked to him earlier today. He said, you know what? I just wanted to successfully defend my crown once. That would have been a good series. And now he's done it three times and dropped a 300. Two more successful defenses this week and next week. That'll mean $50,000 he pocketed.
It's like winning two tour titles.
Here's John Nolen. John Nolen, 29-year-old from Waterford, Michigan, won his first career title and his first career major when he won this season's USBC Masters in Las Vegas. It was his first ever championship round appearance, and it was one of the more dominating weeks of bowling anyone witnessed this year on the tour. Curls home the spare. And now he gives way to last two seasons ago, the Rookie of the Year, Rhino Page, the youngest competitor in the PBA King of the Hill competition. Rhino Page from Topeka, Kansas.
And who can forget what he did two seasons ago when he made five telecasts coming out of the TQR, won a title. The guy was just probably the best rookie performance that I could ever remember.
It was the biggest no-brainer Rookie of the Year vote ever in perhaps any sport. Rhino made three shows this past season. The first was mid-December, Lumber Liquidators Shark Championship in Baltimore, Maryland, and he just happened to defeat some guy named Wes Malott, 197-189. So Rhino has some history over the King, at least over the last couple months. The second time at the Tournament of Champions in Las Vegas. Smooth. He's fun to watch when he's dialed in.
Yeah, he gets a little amped up. Remember what he talked about in our pregame meetings? He said it's vital for me to stay up the back of the ball and roll it, and that's exactly what he did there.
And there's John Nolen, and you see the tape job on his right wrist.
Damaged tendon from all of the bowling he's done in his short career.
Gets a strike of his own to match Page.
A little bit different timing. It's late timing. That's why his feet are slow. Gets in a pretty good position there and then kind of stands up straight-legged on it. But make no mistake about it, you don't win a major without having some skill.
Does anybody begin their backswing that low with the ball so close to the wood as John Nolen? It seems, I mean, maybe it's just to me and the way he approaches it, it seems so low the way he begins.
Richie Allen gets tipped over like that. Right. I mean, there's quite a few guys that tip early and get it low. That's just early timing, and that's a result of him trying to throw it hard on this oil pattern. Tries to get the ball in to the swing a little bit earlier so he can throw it hard enough, but instead the ball gets there too quick, and that's always going to result in a pull.
That's like a strong-armed quarterback trying to throw one into double coverage there.
He's just going to try to get the ball over here into the 3-6-10 area and slide the 3 over into the 7.
Misses the 3, which means he misses the 7 as well. So an open frame for Nolen in the third. He sits down at 46, down 14.
Another name that comes to mind when you're talking about that real low starting position, guy by the name of Marshall Holman. He used to start with the ball down there.
There's Rhino's number this year. Eighth in the Player of the Year points race, ninth in earnings.
Tip. Oh, yeah, baby!
Gets the tip and gets them all to kick. Strike number two for Rhino Page. The lead swells to 24.
Well, you heard him yelling tip, tip, tip. That's because he wants this ball to hook up, and it does right at the last minute. That would be a wall shot there, Rob. A little light mixer, wall shot. Use any one of those that you feel is necessary in describing that shot there. I don't know.
I smell an opportunity, Randy. Three in a row for Paige.
It wasn't me.
Paige takes a seat, and he's a very passionate bowler when he's on the lane, sometimes to his detriment. He'll admit that.
When Rhino Page gets all fired up like that, he kind of reminds me of a ferret on a double espresso. He's just so amped.
He's the 10.
Pretty good shot there for a rigging 10, and John Nolen just somehow trying to get back into this match, and the only way to do that is keep hitting the pocket. But because of the ball speed, I think that the best strike angle in this building, Wes Malott has proved that you have to use a little bit more angle. So if that means Nolen getting a little softer with his speed, that's what he's got to do.
John converts his second spare. Next year will be his first as an exempt player on the tour, but he's been on the road a lot this season with the PBA, and he realized quickly it's a little bit different.
When you get out on the road, you got to bowl maybe more than you do when you're back home because of the tiredness in the legs and the driving and the fatigue. So to stay on, you know, stay on top of your game, you know, you really got to log some time and try to remain as calm as possible. You know, don't get too overwhelmed with everything that's going on. You know, you kind of got to stick to the game plan. You know, stick to what got you here.
Yeah, and it's really easy to once you've won and had early success, it's not that hard to feel like that's going to happen to you every week out here.
We talked to him today about his his win in Vegas at the USBC Masters, and he said, "Look, guys, it's been really rough since then. You know, the next three tournaments after that, I try to win them all on Wednesday. It's been a mental struggle. My expectations are kind of beyond what I can reach right now." Thinks he can go out and win every tournament, and he realized quickly that is not the case. You know, don't be disappointed if you don't get perfection every single throw. Oof. And another open frame for Nolen, although a game challenge there. Wes Malott telling us, you know, he thought John Nolen might give him a decent run for the money if he could get by Rhino Page. But right now, Wes Malott sitting in the catbird seat saying, the throne, I don't think is going to be challenged by John Nolen at this juncture through four and a half. Rhino Page working on a three-bagger. Shake off that 7-10 and chew on a ham bone.
Well, he increases the lead to 60 now. Check this out. Pocket 7-10. 7 goes, 10 goes.
Kegel carry,
and
baby.
Life is good.
Now, you just heard Rhino Page say kegel carry, and you and I were discussing that earlier today. And for those who are not familiar with this facility, why is there so much carry here?
The sidewalls are lively and the pins are on spot.
Not wood. Loaded with, were they talking titanium plates or something? I mean, just huge bounce effect off those.
Magnesium, maybe?
Sounds like you're in the biology lab. Magnesium?
Titanium or magnesium kick plates.
Sounds good. I'll go with it.
But since I've never actually worked in the back of a bowling center, I can't really remember.
You've never worked back there?
No. I worked up front.
Doing what? Schlepping sodas and hot dogs?
Cleaning. I was a porter. And I kept score in league.
That's why you're so good with math.
To make my practice money for the next day.
Big lead for Rhino Page, 58 after 5.5 frames.
When we return, the conclusion of match number one. Can Rhino Page keep the streak going and get a shot at Wes Malott's throne? Find out with us when we return to the Kegel Training Center in Lake Wales, Florida. ESPN's coverage of the PBA King of Bowling powered by AMP rolls on from Lake Wales, Florida. I want to remind you the final of our five shows in this series comes your way next Wednesday night, 9 Eastern here on ESPN2. Brad Angelo taking on PBA Hall of Famer Parker Bone III for the right to face today's King 1 week from today here on ESPN2. Nolen to close out the sixth. Whoa. How about that for a strike? That hung right for a long time, it seems.
There's a little return from out if you get a good, you know, good amount of paw in the bottom of that swing there, and he catches all of that one. Cat's comparison. Rhino Page left-handed around the eighth board. That's the measured at the 15-foot mark where the arrows are. Nolen 7.5 board, but Katz is telling me that that last shot was about 4 boards right. So it looks like he may have made an adjustment and moved right on that right lane. Let's see if it works on the left.
2 in a row, 4. Smooth rolling, John Nolen.
And indeed, he's moved to the right on both lanes. Velocity is about the same at 20 miles an hour.
Sounds like a jazz artist, doesn't it? Or maybe a late night radio show on W Jazz.
Smooth rolling, John.
Smooth rolling, John. The quiet storm. Here's Page to conclude the seventh, up 48. Seemed to take a while to get there.
It's burning up.
You know, not to jump ahead or anything, Rob, but the one thing that we have not seen throughout this series is Wes Malott struggling to get to the pocket and strike. Unfortunately for the winner of this match, it's not the same story. Although Rhino Page did have a 4-bagger, the last 2 shots both went high. And right now, Wes Malott looks like he looks like he needs a drool bucket.
What kind of king has Wes Malott been so far? Is he going to be like?
He's been a bully, really.
He's been bulletproof. Is he going to be remembered like King Henry VIII, where he had 6 wives, 2 of whom he ordered to be beheaded? Or is he going to be a benevolent king? A King Lear? Maybe King Louis XIV? How about King John of England, the archenemy of Robin Hood? Can you tell I had some time on the Wikipedia on that internet thing the other day?
There you go.
Page jacks them in the 8th.
Lead is 46, Nolen working on a double.
The best John Nolen can shoot, 220. Rhino Page already at 226.
Oh no.
Brooklyn, baby.
Boy, that was heading into the moat. And all of a sudden it looked like somebody kicked it left. There's your friction, the outside part of the lane.
You heard him go, oh no, right there.
I mean, that there's only about six or seven boards that ball did not pass at some point.
Yeah, well, it was heading right very quickly and found some friction. Mm. Otherwise, it would have been zero.
It went east to west mighty quickly. Reggie Bush-esque. Never really got in a groove today, did John Nolen.
And I kind of get the feeling that if there's one chink in his armor, it's probably throwing it straight and hard. Straight, not so much, but I think it's the speed thing. And anytime you see somebody with late timing, as John has, it's a little bit tougher for them to throw the ball faster without arming it. When we watched him win the Masters, he was nice and soft at the bottom. He could keep his speed down and really work his hand, and that's pretty much how he dominated that event. But I can promise you this, during the offseason, that's one area of his game that he'll work very, very hard on, because he's committed to getting into great shape. He's got a two-year exemption, and he's going to leave nothing to chance.
Yeah, he told us today he went for a 12-minute run, and he was dead tired at the end of it. That has got to change before next season.
Coming for you, baby. Coming for you. Don't get too comfortable over there.
Page makes it a double and begins the taunting of the throne. He told us that today. He said, I love my chances versus Wes Malott. I'm going to rattle him. I am going to get in his cage.
You know what happens? You bowl the really big game, and then you bowl me, right?
Referring to the 300 last week.
Hey, Rhino, be careful what you wish for.
The king can come down hard.
I'd hate to see the punishment.
You don't want to be beheaded by the king. But watch out, Rhino can slay a few dragons out here now.
Dead loose now?
See, now he's got
loose now?
Oh, now he's got Malott talking.
Just in time. Figure I probably need 12 of those at least to tie.
So Page moves on and begins his early attack on Wes Malott's throne.
Oh boy.
Yeah. Oh,
really?
Oh, don't let that get hot.
That's gonna be in the T50s, and that's a really good game. Unfortunately, it's 20 light of what Wes Malott's been averaging.
Has eight strikes already. Has already won this. And this to conclude.
Finish it all!
Make it nine.
Come on, buddy. Come on,
so Rhino Page rolls over John Nolen. Up next, the king, Wes Malott. Page takes a seat with a 256. Nolen rolls out in the 10th.
That's appropriate.
Well, he's one of the nicest guys you'll meet out here on this tour, and look forward to seeing John in a full-time role, not having to go through the TQR, which is the tour qualifying rounds. He is a full exempt player for next season. See if he can parlay that Masters title to some big money next season on the Lumber Liquidators PBA Tour.
Yeah.
Thank you, Kegel. Thank you.
At that point, it's like, let's just wrap this up here. And
yeah, let's get out of here. Thanks, everybody. I'll see you. I'm out of here.
Let vacation begin. Rhino Page, Goris Nolen, 256 to 176. Up next, the big man, the big target, the big nasty, Wes Malott.
The PBA, in conjunction with Luby Publishing, has produced a collector's edition book featuring the 50 greatest bowlers in PBA history. This book, through its use of pictures and feature stories, great way to revisit the careers and relive the moments that made these players legendary. To order, simply head to PBA.com and click on the Shop tab today link. Now we go laneside. Brienne standing by with Rhino Page.
Thanks, Rob. Rhino Page moves on to play the king, Wes Malott. The trash talking's already started a little bit, Rhino. Do you think it's possible to rattle the king's cage?
Well, I'll try to. He's an awful big guy, you know, so, you know, being so small, it's hard to intimidate him. But I've had his number on TV this year, so I look forward to trying to take that into this match.
Now, some people may not know this about you, but Rhino actually studied at one point to become a weatherman. So I'm going to see, will you give us your forecast for your match against Malott?
Well, I look for the Florida sunny skies to give way to a storm. And some pins are going to be blowing around.
It doesn't get much better than that, guys.
Rhino Page, Wes Malott for the title of king when we return. We welcome you back to our continuing coverage of the PBA King of Bowling, powered by AMP. Rob Stone, Randy Peterson, Brienne Pettigo here with you tonight. The final of our five shows in this King of Bowling series comes your way 1 week from tonight, 9 p.m. Eastern, here on ESPN2. Brad Angelo and PBA Hall of Famer Parker Bone III will duel for the right to face today's king. And today's king will be either the lefty Rhino Page, big nasty Wes Malott. Wes Malott has spent so much time on that throne that he has had a recliner built in. He's got the cushion working just perfectly to his shape.
He's been in that chair for a long time. Mm-hmm.
That's the start for the southpaw that he wanted. Rolled a 256 last game versus John Nolen, dropping 9 strikes. Page just completed his sophomore campaign on the PBA Tour. Made 3 shows, winning 1, and it was the first that he made on TV. And he beat Wes Malott in that title match. 197-189, December 14th of 08 in Baltimore. Here is Wes Malott, nothing short of dominant as the king of bowling. That's the worst shot we've seen from him as king, I believe.
I don't think he's got less than 9 spare ever. And I think out of 36 shots in 3 games, he's thrown 32 strikes. Right now, staring at the 2-4-10. Remember, these two have history. Rhino Page has beaten Wes twice this season. Once in Baltimore after Wes came off of a 290 game. How about it? Oh!
I don't think Wes saw that.
He's having approach issues. He's sticking on the approach. He doesn't like that. He was going through that in practice.
Well, he's always meticulous with that brush on the shoes. You always see him working it, but there was a long delay here on the site as they worked on the approach. That is a huge pickup for Wes.
The king is cranky right now, irritated with a little approach issue.
Come on.
Come on! Get over it, baby. Come on.
He's back.
Remember, this match for another $10,000. Wes Malott's already pocketed 30 grand. And this is more like it, huh?
And we want to remind you, at the end of each show, the king will have the opportunity to convert those 3 special spare shots. If he hits all 3 in order, there's another $10,000 bonus. Make it a double for Rhino Page to start.
You see the difference in the two styles of Rhino Page and John Nolen, who we saw in our last match. They're both 4-step approaches, but Rhino gets the ball started first which gets his feet to go very, very quickly. John Nolen, on the other hand, steps first, ball second. That's why his footwork is slow. So two completely different timings, two different setups. Rhino Page's footwork much faster.
Is one right and one wrong, or is that just the way each person goes?
One's good when you have to be soft. The other one's good when you have to be firm. But the key is being able to adjust to be able to do both.
Yeah! New king in town, baby!
Rot roll, Raggy!
3-0 for Rhino.
Now watch this beautiful shot right here. He posted up nicely. Follow through going in front of the face. That's the big thing nowadays. And then for some reason, he's really angry at the cameraman.
Cameraman Charles has agitated a lot of bowlers through the season. We love Charles. Wes in the third, coming off a strike in the second.
The king has returned. Long live the king.
It's good to be the king. It's been a benevolent rule under Wes Malott. He lowered taxes.
He did?
He made the peasants happy.
He did?
He gave acreage to his serfs.
I got nothing?
You missed that.
Back in our pre-game or pre-shot routine and act like it never even happened.
Malott down 10. We begin the fourth. Three in a row for the big nasty.
He's gonna have
we're
to
all
earn
tied
it.
Up to three and a half. You're right, the king is a little surly right now. This is the first real kind of legitimate threat to his throne.
Absolutely, and he means business. You know, after all the trash talking by Rhino Page, he's looking to ride Rhino Page like his normal steed.
Nice use of the word steed. Opens with the ham bone, this Rhino Page.
This is a huge break right here. Comes in light,
I've ever seen, but.
Trips the 3-9 late. And is it possible? Could it be? Does Rhino Page have the king's number?
We're only through four. That's all I'm telling you.
Okay.
No offense to Rhino, but we're only through four. And Wes has been the king for a long time for a reason.
Yahtzee, baby!
Yahtzee!
He's throwing dice at you. Quick, catch those. It might be worth something.
Oh, baby, I'm hot tonight. Will we see how a lefty will lead the PBA kingdom? Malott had a huge 2-4-10 conversion for a spare in the first. Since then, a three-bagger.
Come on, roll it.
Again, coming off a 300 game last week when he took down Walter A. Williams Jr. Believe it or not, that's actually fairly good news.
Oh boy.
As he walks back to the ball return, because it was about that close to a 7-10.
And the drawbridge is starting to lower. Rhino Page starting to see a little daylight into the kingdom of Wesley.
Right, you gotta cut off. Somebody's kind of trying to take your throne. Got a preemptive strike, right, Randy?
Absolutely. Look out.
Oh, a little kick.
Pretty fair competition right here. A lot of confidence in that shot.
That ball's actually
out of bounds.
Yes, in the gutter before it gets to the seven pin, so it does not count. Wes Malott, the first chink in the armor since ruling his kingdom. Rhino Page looking to become the new ruler.
King bounces back with a strike.
Very agitated, my friend.
In the sixth, he takes a seat on the throne. How much longer will he have that accommodation? Rhino Page tearing it up through five. He is perfect with a 33-pin lead. The conclusion of today's King of Bowling episode coming up after this break. Yahtzee! The King is in trouble. We welcome you back to the PBA King of Bowling, powered by AMP here on ESPN2. And Rhino Page with a chance to dethrone Wes Malott as we take a look at our AMP power stats.
And Wes Malott's definitely going to win the power part of this. You see his rev rate at 415. Surprisingly low rev rate, though, for Rhino Page. I would have thought his rev rate much higher than that. But the only thing that really matters right now, Rob, is that Rhino Page is leading by 33 in this match and looking to dethrone Wes Malott for the first time in this event.
Again, Wes Malott has taken down Chris Barnes, Patrick Allen, and Walter A. Williams Jr., all three of those guys, former players of the year. It has not been an easy march, but he has just stormed through them. But watch out, Wes. Rhino Page looking for six in a row to open up.
Wow, 9.5.
Yeah, we've seen that fall.
Oh, yeah. Surprised it didn't.
It's payback for the last one, honestly.
And I think this may be the only trouble spot for Rhino Page in terms of carry. His ball looks like it's a little softer when it enters the pocket on the right lane. Looks like he's locked in on the left.
I love watching Rhino Page chuck a single pin spare ball. I mean, he's angry. It's a venomous toss.
It's got bad intentions written all over it.
I'm also intrigued by the discrepancy in forearm size between Rhino Page's left and right. I know you see that across the PBA, but for him, it is so profound.
Really?
Whoa.
The King may be cracking a smile here.
Wow.
A lot of work to do for Wes Malott, but
sweet.
Suddenly, Rhino Page having some issues in the sixth and now the seventh.
Yeah, bad break here. He goes a little bit high and leaves a 6-8. And if there's one thing that history has taught us over the last couple years working with you, Rob, it's that you never give a great player an opening. That's why every time I bowl you, I just try to knock you down early and keep you down.
Bounce.
Open frame.
Usually with a foot somewhere planted squarely on your throat.
Yeah. The trachea has been bruised many a time, courtesy of you, and I appreciate that. The lead at 19 for Rhino Page. He takes a seat at a 166. Wes Malott, four strikes through six frames. An open frame in the fifth that may come back to haunt him.
He can actually take the lead by throwing two strikes right here. And remember, he did miss the seven pin in the fifth frame.
Went in the gutter, bounced out, nicked the pin, did not count. OB.
Get it back!
Never count the King out. He's rallying his troops. And the drawbridge starts to go back up a little bit around the moat.
Yep, I see that. I hear you.
He hasn't quite ordered his feast yet. The wine and the meats and the cheeses and the grapes and the fruit, but he's getting ready to talk to the caterer.
Not sure what all that means, Rob, but
let's see. Way to work with me, Randy.
Let's see if
one.
He can catch a strike here and take the lead for the first time in this match.
Team player Peterson.
we begin the eighth.
Uno, dos, tres.
Just in the lead right there. Pretty good stuff. We've now got a barn burner here, Robbie.
A Royal Rumble in Lake Wales.
You haven't seen that energy, that vocal enthusiasm from Wes Malott tonight until just then. And now he sits on his throne, on his perch, and views one of his loyal subjects, Rhino Page, step up in the eighth.
Rhino Page shot 256 in his first match against John Nolen. If he strikes out in the ninth and tenth, he'll once again shoot 256. The problem, he can't shut out Wes Malott.
How's that for a 307 rev rate?
Hey, Rhino, I'm just going by what the CAT system's telling me.
I like the fact that Rhino's listening to us. Nothing gets by the young man from Topeka, Kansas.
Took offense to that 307 rev rate.
But with a smile on his face. Page opened up with five straight strikes, looking for a two-bagger here in the nine.
Make him work.
And we'll get it.
Make him work.
So he will sit down and will know what he has to do if he even gets the chance to beat Wes Malott, because Malott will step up with a chance to close him out.
Make him work.
Make him work. Don't just hand him the throne. Make him earn it again for the fourth straight week.
See what he's got. Strikes in the ninth and striking out in the tenth. He will shut out Rhino Page by one.
Needs four consecutive strikes on top of the three in a row he's just thrown. Yeah, late messenger does the job.
Are you kidding me? Wow. Talk about some serious pin carry. Check this out. Oh, no, seven pin. Whoop. What?
That thing did a complete flip.
It's still standing.
Landed
up
on somebody and then rolled over. I know. And I just gave a little nudge.
Calm down.
A little nudge to the gutter. Needs three more strikes to retain his title as king of PBA. That's a big one.
King of PBAville.
Yeah, that works.
That's not bad.
Yeah, I like that.
This guy's just a complete animal. And then when you get him on his favorite oil pattern, he's a beast. Two more, he wins and shuts out Rhino Page, because the best Rhino Page can shoot 256.
Come on, come on, come on, come on. Got it! One more to retain the title.
This guy's incredible. His ball reads this oil pattern better than anybody on the tour, and you talk to the top players like a Chris Barnes, like a Norm Duke, and they all say the same thing. You get Wes Malott on a scorpion oil pattern, good luck.
There was a serious mutiny being pitched right now by Rhino Page, a threat to Wes Malott's crown. Wes, an uncharacteristic start, three strikes, a spare, and an open frame through the first five. Since then, it's been six consecutive strikes, a seventh, and he moves on and retains the title. Does he have it? Yeah! The king lives! Oh, bow to the king!
How about a $10,000 messenger?
Oh, my! Get out of here. What a test Rhino Page threw out at him. Here it is.
Good shot.
257. His lowest score yet here in the King of Bowling competition, but it's enough to fend off Rhino Page. We'll hear from our king when we return.
The PBA King of Bowling, powered by AMP, is brought to you by AMP. AMP up, ampenergy.com. By GEICO, 15 minutes could save you 15% on car insurance. And by CLR. CLR, all kinds of dirty, one kind of clean.
Time now for our GEICO Championship recap. As always, Randall.
Match number one, John Nolen, Rhino Page. Rhino Page
coming for you.
Sending out a little message to the king. And in our title match, Wes Malott gets up and needs all three in the 10th to retain the crown. There's two. And how about the last one? A messenger sending a little message to the kingdom. Now let's go down to Brienne with the king.
Randy, boy, that one was close. One pin, but you're still the king. You had some problems with the approach before that game started. How did that affect your game at all?
Well, the left side seemed a little bit tacky, and it's one of those things that sometimes can be an obstacle out here, and you just have to overcome it. And that's what I kept telling myself and bouncing back and making great shots. And that to put yourself in that position and have to strike out to win a match is what we're all out here for. And I've been in that position and I've thrown great shots and haven't quite gotten the breaks, and I finally got the breaks, and that's what it's all about. It's awesome.
In case anybody's counting, that's $40,000 now.
And Wes has a chance to add another quick $10,000 to that total right now, Brienne, courtesy of the King's Spare Challenge. If he knocks down all three of these spare conversions in a row, get a fat $10,000 check. We begin with the 3-10, also known as the
baby split.
Then the 1-2-4-10
washout.
And finally the 4-6-7-9-10.
It's the Greek church or grandma's teeth, depending on what side of the country you live in.
First up, baby split, and we're done.
Still not much confidence there.
Okay.
He may not have confidence in the spare game, but boy, he's got a lot of confidence as king.
Who knows?
He moves on to week number 5. Can he continue to retain his title?
Can't stop saying it.
It'll be Brad Angelo or Parker Bone III trying to dethrone Wes Malott. He withstood his stiffest challenge yet, Randy.
Yeah, he only shot 257 that game, Rob. His average is starting to plummet.
Plummet.
I think it's somewhere in the 260s now.
Yeah, nosedive by a decimal point. For Randy Peterson, Brienne Pettigo, and our entire ESPN crew, I'm Rob Stone. Thanks for watching the PBA King of Bowling. We'll see you again next Wednesday night, where Wes Malott defends his title.